This is a special news report. One of the worst mass shootings in U.S. history happened on Sunday, June 12, 2016, during the 2 a.m. hour at a gay nightclub in Orlando, Florida. One gunman, caught in the act, was shot dead by the police. The investigators found that the gunman was a 29-year-old U.S. citizen with the name Omar Mateen. It's reported that his ethnic background is Afghani, and he was investigated twice by the FBI for possibly having a connection to terrorists in 2013 and 2014. But in both cases, his past FBI investigations were closed due to limited information that was found. Then in his personal life, his ex-wife stated that he was abusive and unstable. Still, Mateen managed to keep a clean record, and he even worked as a security guard. For these reasons, it presents a mystery to why he would brutally open fire on bystanders. Reporters questioned if the attack in Orlando was linked to ISIS, because public shooting was similar to the ISIS-linked shooting that took place in Paris in 2015. Omar Mateen resided with his family. And his father stated that he did not believe the shooting was about religion, like the Paris attack, because his son had anti-gay beliefs. Mateen's father reported to investigators that he believed that his son's shooting was targeted against gays due to the fact that his shooting was at a gay club. But investigator findings reveal a deeper reason to why Mateen conducted the shooting. Investigators found that while Mateen was carrying out his massacre, that he managed to call 911 in the process. It was reported that he gave his full name to the 911 operator, and he pledged his allegiance to ISIS. He also mentioned the 2013 Boston bombings. Investigators state that they have not received any claims of responsibility from ISIS. They explain that Omar Mateen's shooting spree could have been ISIS-inspired, considering the amount of recruiting and motivational videos they are making public on the internet for people to convert to ISIS and fight. Investigators report that this may be the case for Omar Mateen and his shooting spree, most likely was ISIS inspired. Now, considering the group is against homosexuality, he demonstrated his allegiance to the Islamic State in the most unfortunate way that resulted in the death of many. So now the question presents itself: could mass shootings become a common occurrence in the US? If so, what's the best possible solution to prevent it? Does the US need to ban guns completely, as Obama wishes, when people may still find a way to getting a gun? Or should the US put a temporary ban on Muslims, as Trump suggests, until we find out what's going on? Still, this plan would not be foolproof, because there are many Muslims living in the US that are US citizens, just the same as Omar Mateen was. And another thing, Trump's suggestion would not be foolproof, because not all Muslims are a part of the Islamic State. There are many Muslims that are actually against ISIS.
That's right, I am not part of ISIS, but I am Muslim. So, why should I be banned from the US?
Come state your opinion. What would you suggest to prevent any future mass shootings in the US? Come leave your thoughts. Visit the social networks for Gabby Ray Talker and come check out www.isoclassifieds.com. Thanks for watching.